Traveling locally in a new city in India is intimidating. You are continuously overwhelmed with tricky rickshaw drivers, guides, hawkers, and a whole lot of things. But with the emergence of radio taxis, Google Maps, and the internet, things are much better than before. We are here to help you with local travel for Udaipur city. We wish to create this as a series so that when you go to a destination, it is easier for you to travel locally. So here it is. Let's get started. For Udaipur city, the radio taxis like Uber and Ola work fine. Even to and fro from the airport is cheaper with radio taxis than the prepaid taxi at the airport. If you're around the old city area, which is the area around City Palace, Jagdish Temple, and the banks of Lake Pichola, the roads are quite narrow with absolutely no traffic rules. The radio taxis may or may not agree to enter these areas. Sometimes, even if they agree, they may get stuck in a traffic jam. This particular area is better covered by foot. The rickshaws in Udaipur city are expensive and unreliable. But the old city is the best area to live in. So if you take a rickshaw for transporting luggage or any other reason, please follow these steps. Firstly, go to Google Maps. Check how far your destination is. If it is within 3 kilometers, then quote rupees 40. You shouldn't pay anything more than rupees 70 for such a short distance. If the distance is more than 3 kilometers but less than 6 kilometers, then quote rupees 50. Do not pay anything more than 120 rupees for the ride. And do not pay attention to the rickshaw driver's quote. It is generally unreasonable. Now, if your distance is above 6 kilometers, then we would highly recommend you to take a rickshaw just outside the old city and call a radio taxi from there, from wherever you have to go. Now let's talk about the various attractions that you can reach. All the old city attractions like the City Palace, Jagdish Temple, Bagor Ki Haveli, Gangaur Ghat, Vintage Car Museum, and all the lakeside restaurants and cafes, we would prefer you to insist your radio taxi driver to take you there. But if not, then bargain with a rickshaw driver. Let's discuss individual attractions. First one on the list is the Sajjangarh Palace and the zoo. Now these are on a height. Radio taxis can drop you at the foothills. There are golf carts available for you to get into the zoo, and any other vehicle is not allowed. Whereas, for the Sajjangarh Palace, personal vehicles and radio taxis both are allowed to go on top. Please insist to your radio taxi driver to take you on top of the hill. If not, there is transportation available. But you might have to wait for a longer time, as the shuttle cabs that ferry you to and fro are just two or three in number. We have a separate video discussing Sajjangarh Palace in depth. If you want to know more, then check out the description box. The next is the Karni Mata Temple. Now here, you can take a radio cab till the foothills and then take the cable car to the top. All the other city attractions like Sahelio Ki Bari is well within the city limits and can be reached by radio taxi easily. We suggest you to use Google Maps extensively. It is accurate. Now for outside the city limits, for places like Ranakpur, Kumbhalgarh, etc., you can hire a car. A four-seater car would cost you 2,500 to rupees 3,000. A seven-seater car would cost you about rupees 3,500 to rupees 4,000. All the information that we've shared is as of November of 2016. We hope you enjoy Udaipur as much as we did.
Please subscribe to our channel for travel updates and follow us on social media.